I received this Russian submarine clock for servicing the other day. Sam from California has owned it for over 30 years now. I see the second hand is in need of replacing or repair. To open these, it uses the same key that is used to wind the movement. The minute hand is held on with a threaded collar. Four screws holding the dial on. It's a painted dial, real nice shape. Get this movement out of the case. The case is made of aluminum. Very well made. It was made to last. Nice heavy latch. Not sure what these casting numbers are. Rubber water seal is in excellent shape. The aluminum is painted with an anti-corrosion green paint. Remove the front fastener plate. Using an air bellow on the balance wheel, it looks nice and true. This is the fourth wheel thrust bearing. The fourth wheel has a ring gear that meshes with the escape wheel pinion. Nice looking setup. The exterior regulator arm that adjusts the rate from the dial. It operates the balance wheel regulator arm. Intermediate wheel, minute wheel, hour wheel. Looks like a lot of dried oil and dirt deposits on the gear teeth and pinions. Fourth wheel ring gear meshes nice and smooth with the escape wheel pinion. You can see the click through the click access hole in the plate. Let the mainspring down. These gear teeth have black deposits on them. Dried oil on this pivot. This pivot hole is slightly egg-shaped, but shouldn't affect its function. Mainspring pivot has dried crusty oil around it. In some of these pivot holes, you can see the brass plate and how it's plated with possibly nickel. This pinion is filthy. This is the stuff that causes a lot of wear on clocks. First, I'll remove the balance wheel so it doesn't get damaged. Check to see that there isn't any power to the pallet fork. Escape wheel. These pivots are a little dirty. Plate fasteners. Regulator control arm, minute wheel bridge, hour wheel, minute wheel assembly. It's a type of non-lash gear assembly. It's made of two gears, sandwiched together with a spring to load pressure on the mating pinion. Intermediate gear, tension washer, intermediate wheel, fourth wheel ring gear, mainspring barrel, this is the index mark punched in when it was new. It's mislocated slightly. It tells me the last person in it didn't clock it exactly as it was from the factory. The mainspring barrel is made of brass that's been coated with a corrosion-resistant coating. The spring is still under power since it has a Geneva stop mechanism on it. I've released the power from the stop mechanism. You can either pry this barrel cap off or use a brass hammer to remove the cap. If you use a hammer, it should be a quick light hit with a snap motion, and the cap will pop out on the first hit. Lots of old black dried grease in here. These score marks on the mainspring surface are from when it was formed, when it was made brand new. Boy, the grease is really used up in here. Ratchet wheel, second wheel, looking at the pivot holes, they are all dried and in need of cleaning. Just look at the dried oil residue on this jewel. Mainspring arbor pivot hole. I haven't seen any signs of oil yet. The whole movement has been running dry for quite a while. Movement is all cleaned except for the balance assembly. Screws for the cap jewel are accessed from the underside. First, the regulator assembly needs to be turned to release the hairspring. Now to loosen the hairspring stud screw. A gentle nudge on the hairspring stud, and the balance assembly will drop free. Nice. I'll put the balance wheel under a glass dome to protect it. Screw the screw in so it doesn't get lost. Now the cap jewel screws. The cap jewel is packed with dried oil. You can see where the balance pivot rides, right in the middle of all the gunk. Balance jewel looks good. It's all cleaned and time to oil the cap jewel. One drop from a small oiler is all it needs. Now to put the balance wheel back in. Oil the other balance wheel cap jewel. Oil the escape wheel cap jewel. Now the fourth wheel thrust bearing. I marked the bridge here with the screw slot, so it gets back exactly where it was. Now to assemble it. Oil the front plate. These minute wheel gears need to be spring-loaded before installation. The minute wheel on these are the anti-backlash type. It's two gears, sandwiched together, connected to the same shaft. One fixed and one floating. A spring keeps a slight force on one gear relative to the other. It prevents all backlash in the system connected to it. Gives a very precise and repeatable position of this gear and ones connected to it. They're used a lot in robotics and in the medical industry, where exact positioning time after time is needed. They're also used in some truck and automotive transmissions to keep backlash to a minimum. In these clocks, it prevents backlash movement of the hands. It's a way to have repeatable, precise positioning of the hands. Ingenious idea. Oil the rear plate. Escape wheel. Oil the pallet fork jewels. Just a drop of oil on the receiving surfaces is all it needs. Pallet Fork Bridge. Balance assembly. Nice, it's running already. The hairspring stud is loose. I'll snug it up later. You can see the pallet fork jewels working along with the escape wheel teeth. Sure, a nice looking dial on this clock. Now the broken second hand to deal with. We've decided to mount a replacement. Now this one is too light in color. I'll search for a couple that might be able to be modified. These are all too light in color. This is another possible one to use. The mounting arbor on them are not close enough to interchange with each other. The original one is quite longer. Time to modify a couple items. First, I'll cut the old remains of the original hand off. Now to remove the replacement hand from its center mount. Need to do this without cutting into the hand itself. Nice. Didn't even touch the surface of the hand with the cutter. The hole in this replacement hand is too large, so I made a brass collar to size it down to the original center mount. The collar fits the hand perfect. Here's the original center arbor. It fits into the center of the collar. It will be fit into the center of the collar and then will be swaged onto the collar. This flat hollow punch will nest against the brass collar. And press it onto the original center arbor. It seats nice and snug. Now to swage the brass over the collar. I'll use a rounded punch. Should work out just fine. Now to trim it for length. Works great. A nice example of a Russian submarine clock.